Have you ever watched a streamer and all of a sudden during their stream, their voice changes? And you're like, whoa, how did they do that? What software did they use to do that? How can I do that on my stream? I bet you that streamer used something expensive like the Go XLR. Or maybe the streamer used an interface or an amp to get these all voice changes done. Well, all you need is a piece of equipment you most likely already own. You just need this guy right here, an Elgato Stream Deck. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how you can take this and make it change your voice into something just like this. Let's go. Hey, it's me, it's Wild, coming at you for my stream support playlist where I bring you the best tips and tricks. And if this is your first time here and you wanna learn how to grow and improve your stream, make sure you hit that big red subscribe button and tick that bell so you know when my videos go live for you. And hey, at any point in this video, if you like the products or the services that I'm talking about, did you all a favor? I put links in the show notes below, so make sure you check them out. Depending on the type of streamer you are and the community you have built, you may want to introduce some fun, charismatic tools to your stream to make everything a little more fun and engaging. And adding a voice changer or voice modulator may be one of those tools you want to introduce to your community. Now, if you already own an Elgato Stream Deck, regardless if it's the regular one like this one I'm holding here or the mini, you can use something that's really cool that Elgato introduced not too long ago. They opened up an SDK which allows third-party platforms and programmers to develop things like extensions, plugins, add-ons to the Elgato Stream Deck. Hence, they basically made an app store. And within this app store, you can do something really cool. You can turn this into a voice changer. So let me go over to the computer and allow me to show you what you need to do to introduce this tool to your stream. Please make sure you have your Stream Deck software up to date or this may not work for you. When you're ready to download the app, go down to the bottom right corner for more actions and there you can see all the apps you want to download. Look for Voice Mod, download and install. Please note you'll need an additional download from Voice Mod Direct to access their voice filters. Now that you have the app installed and you have the software installed, go back to your Elgato Stream Deck and scroll all the way to the bottom and there you'll see Voice Mod. Click it open and here you'll see all the options: Select Voice, Hear My Voice, Voice Changer, Ambient Effects, Mute, and Push to Voice. The only two that we're really concerned about are Push to Voice and Select Voice. Play around with the other options on your own free time. Before we can start using Voice Mod on our Elgato Stream Deck, we actually have to configure it for our input for our microphone and our output for our source that we're going to be using it in. If you haven't launched Voice Mod yet, make sure you do so on your desktop so that way you can get to this screen. Once you're on the home screen, go over to the left-hand ledger and click on the cogwheel, and here it'll let you select your input device, which will be your microphone, and your output device, which will be any one of the sources that you need to use it for your streaming adventures or any of your content creations that you're gonna be using Voice Mod for. Now that we configured Voice Mod, we also have to configure our OBS so that way it's going to recognize that input as a source. So rather than having your microphone be selected, you want to make sure that Voice Mod is selected so that way when you make the changes on the filter effects, they will play through your OBS broadcasting software and that way people that you're broadcasting to can hear the changes. Okay, now we can start finally having some fun with Voice Mod. At the very top bar are all the free voices that you get to use on your Elgato Stream Deck, and I've been told that they rotate these out. I'm not sure if it's weekly or monthly, but at least you get to try new sources all the time. Below that are the pro voices that you can pay for, and they have different pay options, and you do get a lot of options here for all the voices that you can select from. If you're interested in doing a paid option, you can go to the bottom right-hand corner where you can click on the pro service, or you can go over to the left badge and click on there. There you can see it's $5 for 3 months, $10 for a year, or you can do the lifetime for $20. Just to let you know, I'm not affiliated with any way of Voice Mod. I just think this is a cool program that I wanted to share. To add filter effects to our Elgato Stream Deck, go ahead and click and drag the select voice off. I recommend making your first one a no effect so you have something to go back to. Let's try out the Android voice. We'll put it right here and let's grab another one and let's go ahead and select the Dark Angel and let's do one more and we'll put this right here and we'll select the Wah Wah voice. Now that we have this all set up, let's push on our Elgato Stream Deck and test out the voices.
So here is my voice on the Android setting, and you can hear me sound like a fun little robot.
Here is my voice on the Dark Angel setting for mysterious content that I can make.
And here is my voice on the Wawa setting, which makes me sound a little like I am under the water.
Now please note, to make any of these voice filters, voice modulations, voice changes work for your stream, you do have to have VoiceMod running, and you have to have the software running in the background for any of this to work. So please remember that. Now the Elgato App Store is really cool. It gives you a really affordable way to introduce a lot of tools like the voice changing and voice modulation. If you don't have an Elgato Stream Deck, you would have to go around the routes of generally getting something like a big beefy boy like the Go XLR, which will cost you about 400 USD, or you'd have to get like an interface or a preamp, which can cost you anywhere from about 100 to 200 bucks, depending on which one you want to go with. The Elgato Stream Deck really does fall into a sweet spot for the sheer reason that with this new app store, it becomes a multitasker, which I love. I love the fact that it can do multiple things, not just for streaming, like changing scenes, opening up certain applications, muting your mic, and now voice modulation. But with the addition of this app store, there's gonna be so much more things on the horizon. Plus the fact it can just do regular desktop tasks if you're not even streaming. And that's why I really recommend getting one of these. Now, if you're interested in an Elgato Stream Deck, they come in two versions. They come in the large, which is the 15 key, which usually runs in around 150 USD, but it's always on sale. Or you can go with the mini, which is a 6 key, which normally runs around 100 USD, but that one's always on sale. So you can sometimes snag that for around 75 USD. As always, links in the show notes below. Like I said, the Elgato Stream Deck is capable of so much more. And if you're interested in a video of maybe the best apps that are coming out for it, or some tips or tricks to help you with your streaming experience, you all know what to do. Leave me a comment below and I will see what I can do to make a video on that. And if you want to check out something really awesome, don't forget to check me on over at twitch.tv/wildforgames, where you can see me paint and give advice all the time with your streaming needs. And if you like what you enjoy there, you can even hit that almighty subscribe button. And thank you to all of those that have already started hitting the join button on this YouTube channel. All the proceeds allow me to keep creating high quality content. Doesn't seem to help with my grammar though. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I will catch you all next time in my stream support videos coming up real soon. Take care, all. Peace.